so magical. Good afternoon, everyone. Today is another magical day. Now, today's video is going to be unique. We are going to be discussing some serious topics, but you know me, I am all about positivity. I love seeing the bright side of as many situations as possible. So today, we are talking about a serious topic, but I'm gonna make it as positive as possible because that's what I like to do. Now, I do wanna start right off the bat by saying I am not a medical professional. I'm not a doctor, I'm not a nurse, I'm not an EMT, I'm not a scientist. I have no official knowledge about viruses or staying well or anything like that. These are just some tips that I use and I pass on to my family and I've heard from friends. Just some general advice that I use to stay well. I also wanna mention that this video in no way, shape, or form is meant to make you feel panic, make you feel fear in any way. This is just me trying to kind of pass on a few tips that I have learned and I've read about so that you can kind of follow along and keep yourself well during any kind of virus or other illnesses that are around. Now, I'm making this video for all vacations, not just for Disney. It includes Disney, of course, but for all vacations and all travel, just so that we can all use it as a reference for the future. Now, at the time of filming, these parks are currently affected by the certain virus that you know right now, which I will not be naming in this video. It's been affecting a lot of people, and its seriousness is known. It's not something to take lightly. So today we're gonna talk about how you can stay well on vacation. Some of the tips that I use, my family use, and friends use. First things first, personal hygiene. Making sure that you wash your hands and keep your hands away from your face as much as possible. And when you have, let's say you have to touch your face, for example, try and use your arm or some other part of your body that's not your hands, because your hands end up touching everything else. You want to try and make sure that it's not your hands if possible. Again, some advice that I use. Now, in keeping with some of those personal hygiene items, you've seen it before, I carry around this Mickey hand sanitizer right there. A friend actually sent this one to me. It's super, super nice. Hang it right there, super convenient. But in response to some very big news all around the world, Disney has started to bring around these hand wash stations. Now, these hand wash stations are super convenient and great for guests to use. You step on the little pedal right there on the ground, use the soap, and then you've got towels up above to rinse your hands and dry them afterwards. I think this is really, really good to see. Hand sanitizer is great, but washing your hands for a full 20 seconds, that's the big one. Now, washing your hands and using hand sanitizer is especially important when you're in high traffic areas or touching things that are touched by many guests. For example, the Buzz Lightyear Space Ranger blaster and control stick right here. I'm going to be touching them, no doubt about it. I'm going to wipe them down very quickly and use hand sanitizer after. Using a little bit of hand sanitizer and a wet wipe here to wipe down the controls prior. Now, you can also just wash your hands afterwards. That helps. Well, that's your first. Take a look. Lights just turned on and these gates just popped up right here. I've never experienced that before. I had Galactic Hero on one. I was working on the other. But this is very interesting. It's been about maybe 3 minutes here and we're still stuck on Buzz Lightyear Space Ranger Spin. That's a surprise.
All the audio turned off. It is eerily quiet. Eerily. Just saw a cast member walk by. Right there. There she goes. Not sure. Maybe just a reset. Battery says not for use in suborbital vehicles. I'm learning a lot just like sitting here. All right, lights just up. There we go. Okay. Going for it right now. I got the 300. Oh my gosh. I gotta see if I can make it. 700. 900. Oh my gosh. I almost made it back to Galactic Hero. Okay, still against right here. I think we're gonna make it. Yes, we did. Back to Galactic Hero. The key here is to try not to touch your phone in between when you're getting the hand sanitizer, washing your hands, because your phone is another surface, and I've learned that it's usually forgotten. I'm sure I forget it all the time. You know, wash hands, sanitize, then touch phone. Now, this applies to you as well. The camera that I hold on to all the time, gotta remember that that's another surface. You gotta clean and make sure, you know, if you touch that, you gotta maybe wipe it down. Every single night, I wipe down the tripod, I wipe down the camera, to make sure it's another clean surface. Now let's discuss a topic that I know might be on your mind. When is it time to cancel vacation just to make sure that you don't get sick or stay well, or if there's, you know, a very serious illness going around that you just wanna make sure you stay home instead of going out and about? That's where something called social distancing comes into play. Social distancing, from what I understand, is when you're in areas that, you know, not as many people go to, so just less people around you in general for less transmission. At Disney, this is especially difficult because even though you can find areas like this where some people aren't around, if you want to stand in a line like here for Space Mountain 120 minutes, you're going to be standing around people the entire time. Social distancing basically means, yes, you avoid areas like Disney World, Disneyland, different Disney parks, because a lot of people are there. You're trying to avoid places where there are a lot of people. The reason why social distancing works so well is because of something called the incubation period. Again, I'm not a scientist, not a doctor, but from what I have read, incubation period is the time when you get the illness and you don't show any of the symptoms. None. No coughing, no sneezing, no fever, nothing. But you're still contagious. When you are social distancing yourself, you're keeping yourself away from large crowds, not going to areas where there are lots of people, concerts, sporting events, theme parks, that kind of thing, you prevent yourself being infected without even knowing it. So even though you say to yourself, I'm gonna run away from someone who's coughing or sneezing, it may have zero effect because the person standing in line right next to you who feels 100% fine, and it is not their fault, may actually have it. Now for the question that nobody wants to ask themselves, nobody wants to think about, should you cancel your vacation due to a worldwide illness? It's not an easy answer. It's not one that I can answer for you. I can't. I simply can't. It's a very personal decision that every individual has to make, you know, and it's not just about one illness. It's not. It can't be just about one. It has to be about your personal situation. You know, things come up in life where you got to say to yourself, okay, this is prioritized over that. Can't answer it for you, not even going to attempt to, but there are always options, and in my opinion, health comes first. Like anything else, the key is repetition. So wash your hands frequently, making sure that you're, you know, not touching your face frequently. You want to think about it over and over and over again. What do I want to make sure I do to keep myself healthy? And I bring this up for a good reason. Even if there's not some global illness going around, it still doesn't hurt to keep yourself healthy as much as possible. Now, we've spoken about hand sanitizer and washing your hands and trying not to touch your face, making sure, this is a big one, covering your cough or sneeze with hand or elbow or tissue would be best, just so that other people don't get infected. That's a big one right there. What about those masks? As soon as we learned about this global virus, a lot of people ran out and bought these masks or other masks. And the question is, do you need one? From what I have read, the mask is best for those who are already sick, not for those who have not been infected yet. It's for those who are sick right now and don't want to infect other people. Now, I do want to remind you, this is from what I have read. I have read that the mask is helpful for those who are sick and don't want to contaminate others. But if you look at it, especially this little blue mask here, there's a lot of openings all around. So how could that prevent something as small as a virus from getting to you? Not so sure about that, especially because I take this off and I touch my face with my hands. You see the problem. So yes, the mask may make you feel better, no doubt about it, but will it prevent a virus? Kind of doubt it. Now, on the topic of the mask, I want to mention that no matter where we go, let's say we go to the mall, the grocery store, the gas station, doesn't matter. Wherever we are in the world, there's a good probability that someone around us or near us or relatively close to us is sick or recovering from an illness or maybe just a little bit sick. Not seriously ill, just a little bit sick. And we don't get sick. Now, in no way, shape, or form is this meant to take away from the seriousness of what the entire world is facing today. Not at all. Not at all. It's just a reminder to us that, you know, the common sense practices, washing your hands, hand sanitizer, just using that, the common sense, just, you know, staying away from, you know, the different handrails and all these things. And if you do have to touch one, wash your hands, those kind of things. It's just a reminder to all of us that illness is part of the world. It's part of the world. It's part of the world we live in. And taking those steps can go a long way. Now let's get back to what Disney has done, and we're seeing a lot of the hand wash stations all over the place. It's not just in Fantasyland, Adventureland too. Not only is it the hand washing stations all around the parks, there's hand sanitizing stations and special information all around so the guests know exactly how to keep themselves healthy while they're here. In addition, for the Disney Cruise Line at the time of filming, Disney has a program where if you cancel your cruise between now and May 31st at the time of filming, no doubt this will change, you can refund it more or less for kind of credit toward another cruise. So you can actually get another cruise with that credit within a year. No penalty at all. You haven't lost a single cent. And on top of that, if let's say this new cruise costs less than the original cruise, the extra money becomes onboard credit. I feel like that's really nice. Now, thinking of strategies, right now at Walt Disney World, to kind of, you know, keep your distance from some of the other guests but still have a magical time, one tip that I highly, highly recommend is leave before the fireworks. It's not something that, you know, it's like every day recommend, but for now, kind of make some room for crowds. It's great because you leave earlier and then the crowds aren't packing in here. Another tip that I was thinking about is why not take like an open air transportation when possible? So for example, the boats right here that take you to the resorts, that to me makes a lot more sense. It's open air, just in case, never hurts. Now, if you skip out on that nighttime entertainment in the parks, don't forget, there's so much to do and see around Walt Disney World and one of my favorites, the resort. And don't forget, you can also see the fireworks from these three resorts, Grand Floridian, Contemporary, and Polynesian. And the other resorts, Boardwalk, for example, has the Surrey bikes. There are a lot of things to do at the different resorts. Now for the serious discussion. Disney's response to this major worldwide illness. I gotta tell you, I have been so impressed with what Disney has done. Not only do they have those hand sanitizers and hand washing stations, they are ready with the cleaning of the ships, they're ready with cleaning all around the parks. You see them constantly wiping down as much as they can, both here in the parks and I've heard on the cruise line as well. They're not just doing all of this, they were proactive. They did this before anyone told them that they had to. They did this just to keep guests safe. And that's why I feel comfortable coming out here, even knowing that, you know what, there could be a closure. There could be a, you know, change in schedule and, you know, there could be people around me who do have an illness. Absolutely. But I trust Disney to do as much as possible, to try and protect all of our health. So what are the biggest takeaways from this video? First up, wash your hands. Wash your hands and don't touch your face. It's gonna help a lot. Second, panic solves nothing. Absolutely nothing. It's great to be prepared, to think ahead, to have hand sanitizer with you, to think about washing your hands, to think about not touching your face, but to panic solves absolutely nothing. My grandmother gave me some great advice a little while ago and reminds me every so often when something that, you know, doesn't quite feel right in your life comes your way. She says, "This too shall pass." And the same thing here. This too shall pass. I know that today's video was a little bit unique, but I think it's important to make sure that we all know about all of the different ways to keep yourself healthy when on vacation, especially at Disney or anywhere else with a lot of people. Sure enough, I made my way back to the transportation and ticket center about to head home, and I read that Walt Disney World, Disney Cruise Line, and Disneyland Paris will also be closing due to this outbreak. Now, this is very scary, but again, not a time to panic. In my, you know, the way I'm thinking about it, Disney went above and beyond. They said, you know what? We prioritize guest safety. We prioritize cast member safety and health. Big one right there. We're gonna pay the cast members and we're gonna close it down for now to make sure that everyone stays healthy. And then when it's safe, we're gonna open it back up. I'm very, very confident in Disney's ability to judge these things and keep us safe. It's unexpected. It's scary for all of us, of course, but you know what? We gotta keep looking forward and stay positive. That's the key. This video is coming out right around the time that the closing is taking place. There's a few more videos I have in store for you, but after all of them are said and done, we are gonna be transitioning to those studio videos and live streams. So stay tuned for all of those. More positivity, more positive thinking, all about Disney, answering your questions. I will be ready for you and I'm looking forward to sharing in more magic that way. And then when the parks open up, we'll be right back to it. So you can still expect a video each and every day. Something to smile about each and every day. That's the important part. Thanks as always for being a part of the magic with me. It means a tremendous amount to be able to share it all with you. Until next time, have a magical day.